Good morning, dear students. Now, today in this lecture, we are going to solve problems on chapter number 4, which is differential equations. In our previous lecture, I already written these two problems, but we did not solve these two problems. So that's why I have written those two problems over here, problem number 7 and 8. We will continue solving all those problems. Okay. Now, first of all, problem number 7. So, solution of problem number 7. Problem number 7 is show that x is equal to 2 is an irregular singular point of differential equation y double dash plus x divided by x minus 2 square y dash plus x plus 2 y is equal to 0. Okay. Now, x is equal to 2 is an irregular singular point of this differential equation. So, x 0 is equal to 2. So, x is equal to x 0 means x is equal to 2 in this problem. So, here in solution, we are writing equation, given equation, which is y double dash plus x divided by x minus 2, okay, into y dash plus x plus 2 into y is equal to 0. Now, compare this differential equation with standard differential equation. We are following the same procedure that we used for solving previous problems. What is that standard equation? Y double dash plus p of x y dash plus q of x y is equal to 0. We get p of x as x divided by x minus 2 and q of x as x plus 2. So, p of x is coefficient of y dash and q of x is coefficient of y. Okay. Now, at x is equal to 2, we have to find out singularity at x is equal to 2. So, we have to take limit as x tends to 2, p of x is equal to limit as x tends to 2, p of x is x divided by x minus 2. So, this is equal to. Now, if you put value of x as 2 in this equation, so 2 divided by 2 minus 2, which is 0, and 2 divided by 0 is infinity. Okay. And limit as x tends to 2, q of x is equal to limit as x tends to 2, q of x, which is x plus 2. Now, if you put value of x as 2 in this limit, we will get 4, which is finite. But since limit as x tends to 2 p of x is infinite, if any one of these limit is infinite, then we can say x is equal to 2 is singular point. Okay. So, therefore, x is equal to 2 is singular point of given differential equation. To find out type of singularity, how we will find out type of singularity? We have to take x minus x0 p of x and x minus x0 square q of x. Okay. Now, here x0 is 2. So, we have to take limit as x tends to 2 x minus 2 p of x, okay, and p of x is what? X divided by x minus 2, and limit as x tends to 2 x minus 2 square q of x, and q of x is what? X plus 2. So, this is x plus 2 is equal to. Now, this x minus 2 will get cancelled, and here we end up with only x. if you put value of this limit as x tends to 2, we will get value as 2, which is finite. Okay. Similarly, here, if you put value of x as 2, so 2 minus 2 square, so 2 minus 2 becomes 0, multiply by 4, so here we get 0, which is finite. Since both these limits are finite, then we know that, therefore, x is equal to 2 is regular singular point. Of given differential equation. Okay. If out of these two limits any one is infinite or both are infinite, then we can say x is equal to 2 is irregular singular point of given differential equation. Now, with this we have solved problem number 7. Now, problem number 8. So, problem number 8 is this. Show that point x is equal to 0 is a regular singular point of differential equation which is given over here 2x square y double dash plus 3x into y dash plus x square minus 4y is equal to 0. Now, this is the given differential equation. We have to convert this differential equation in this form. For that, coefficient of y double dash must be 1. So, we have to divide this differential equation by 2x square. If you divide this differential equation by 2x square, here you will get 1. Okay. Here, 3 upon 2 into x square minus 4, here you have to divide by 2x square. So, differential equation becomes, given differential equation is y double dash plus 3x divided by 2x square. So, x and x square, here we end up with 3 upon 2x plus x square minus 4 and divided by 2x square. So, this is the given differential equation. Okay. Now, we are comparing this differential equation with standard differential equation, which is y double dash plus p of x y dash plus q of x y is equal to 0. We get p of x and q of x as, what is the p of x? 3 divided by 2x, and what is q of x? X square minus 4 divided by 2x square. Now, we have to find out singularity at x is equal to 0. So, we have to take at x is equal to 0, here limit as x tends to 0 p of x and limit as x tends to 0 q of x. So, limit as x tends to 0 p of x and q of x becomes, see, p of x is what? 3 upon 2x. Now, if you put value of x is equal to 0, in this limit, so 3 divided by 2 into 0, so 3 upon 0, which is again infinite. And here, limit as x tends to 0, q of x, which is x square minus 4 divided by 2x square. So, if you put value of x is equal to 0 here, so 0 minus 4, which is minus 4 divided by 2 into 0 square, so minus 4 divided by 0. So, this is again infinite. Now, we know that from definition of singular point, if these two or any one of these two is infinite, then we can say this point x is equal to 0 is singular point of given differential equation. Now, we have to find out type of singularity. So, again, to find out singular type of singularity at x is equal to 0, we have to take limit as x tends to 0, x minus x 0 multiply by p of x. So, here we have to take x 0 is 0, x into p of x. So, x into p of x is 3 upon 2x. Okay. Now, this x will cancel with this x, and if you put value of x is equal to 0, so that will become 3 by 2, which is finite. Okay. Similarly, for q of x, we have to take limit as x tends to 0, x square into q of x. So here we have to take x square into q of x, and q of x is x square minus 4 divided by 2 x square. So this x square will cancel. Okay. And if you put limit as x tends to 0, so 0 minus 4, so this is minus 4, and this is again finite. Now since x p of x and x square p of x both remains finite when we take limit as x tends to 0, therefore we can say x is equal to 0 is regular singular point of given differential equation. Okay. So in this way we can solve problem number 8. Now we are moving to problem number 9. See, problem number 9, show that point x is equal to 0 is an irregular singular point of differential equation, which is given like this: x square x minus 2 square y double dash plus 2 into x minus 2 y dash plus x plus 3 y is equal to 0. So we have to show that x is equal to 0 is irregular singular point of this differential equation. We have to follow same procedure. Now here given differential equation is this: if we divide this differential equation by x square x minus 2 square, why? We have to take coefficient of y double dash as 1. So that differential equation we can write as, see, y double dash, okay, if we divide by x square by x minus 2 square, plus 2 into x minus 2 divided by x square into x minus 2 square, okay, plus here x plus 3 divided by x square into x minus 2 square into y is equal to 0. Now this x minus 2 and x minus 2 square will reduce power of x minus 2 to 1. So again, compare with standard equation, which is y double dash p of x y dash plus q of x y is equal to 0. We get p of x as and q of x as. What is value of p of x? 2 divided by x square into x minus 2, and q of x as coefficient of y, which is x plus 3 divided by x square x minus 2 square. Now we have to find out singularity at x is equal to 0. So at x is equal to 0, we have to take limit as x tends to 0 p of x, and limit as x tends to 0 q of x. Now both these limits, first of all, limit as x tends to 0 p of x, and p of x is what? 2 divided by x square into x minus 2. Now this is equal to, see, if you put x is equal to 0, so 2 divided by 0 multiply by minus 2, so 2 divided by 0, and 2 divided by 0 is again infinite. Okay. Now second limit, limit as x tends to 0 q of x, and q of x is x plus 3 divided by x square into x minus 2 square, this is equal to. Now if you put value of x is equal to 0, so 0 plus 3, in the numerator we have 3, divided by 0 multiplied by 4, so again 3 divided by 0, and which is again infinite. So since both these limits are infinite, we can say x is equal to 0 is singular point of given differential equation. Now we have to find out type of singularity. So for finding type of singularity, again we have to take x into p of x and x square into q of x. So limit as x tends to 0, x p of x is, see, x multiply by p of x, and p of x is what? 2 divided by x square into x minus 2. Okay. Now, this x and x square will reduce power of x to 1. So, 2 divided by x into x minus 2. If you put x is equal to 0, then 2 divided by 0 multiply by minus 2. So, again we get 2 divided by 0, and 2 upon 0 is again infinite. Now, x square into q of x. So, limit as x tends to 0, x square multiply by q of x, which is x plus 3 divided by x square into x minus 2 square. Now, this limit, x square will cancel. If you put value of x is equal to 0 here, so 0 plus 3 is 3 divided by 0 minus 2 square. So, minus 2 square is 4. So, 3 upon 4, which is finite. Okay. But since out of these two, one is infinite, we can say x is equal to 0 is irregular singular point of given differential equation. If both these are finite, then we can say this is regular singular point. If these two or out of these two, any one is infinite, then we can say x is equal to 0 is irregular singular point of given differential equation. So, with this, we finish problem number 9. Okay. Now, we are solving problem number 10. Problem number 10 is show that the point x is equal to 1 is an ordinary point of differential equation 2x square y double dash minus x into y dash plus x minus 5 y is equal to 0. Now again, we are writing given differential equation in this form. For that, coefficient of y double dash must be 1. So we have to divide this equation by 2x square. So, then this differential equation can be written as y double dash minus x divided by 2x square. Okay. So, this x and x square will cancel each other, plus x minus 5. X minus 5 divided by 2x square. Okay. Now, this x will reduce power of this x square. So, here we get 1 upon 2x. So, again, compare with standard equation, which is y double dash p of x y dash q of x y is equal to 0. We get p of x and q of x as. What are p of x and q of x? P of x is minus 1 upon 2x, and q of x is x minus 5 divided by 2x square. Now, we have to check singularity at x is equal to 1. So, we have to take at x is equal to 1, limit as x tends to 1, and limit as x tends to 1, p of x and q of x. Now, first of all, p of x. So, limit as x tends to 1, p of x is what? Minus 1 upon 2x. So, if you put value of x is 1, so that will become minus half, which is finite. Okay. And for limit as x tends to 1, q of x, which is limit as x tends to 1, q of x is what? X minus 5 divided by 2x square is equal to. Now, if you put value of x as 1, so 1 minus 5, which is minus 4. So, minus 4 divided by 2 into x square. So, x is 1. So, this is 2. So, minus 4 upon 2, which is minus 2. So, this is again finite. Since both p of x and q of x remains finite at x is equal to 1, we can say x is equal to 1 is not singular point but ordinary point, okay, of given differential equation. Now here there is no question of finding type of singularity. Okay. Now with this we finish problem number 10. Now problem number 11. So problem number 11 is slight different from previous problems because we have to check singularity at infinity. See, show that the point x is equal to infinity is an essential singular point of or essential singularity of Bessel's differential equation, which is x square y double dash plus x into y dash plus x square minus n square y is equal to 0, where n is order, which is constant. Okay. Now, again, here we are checking singularity at x is equal to infinity. So, for singularity at infinity, we have to follow procedure which is slightly different than previous one. So, in problem number 11, given differential equation is, now again, here we have to convert into this form, that's why divide this equation by x square, okay. So y double dash plus x divided by x square y dash plus x square minus n square divided by x square, and if you divide 0 by x square, so that is again. So, x upon x square, it will reduce power of x to 1, okay. Now, compare this differential equation with standard equation, which is y double dash plus p of x y dash q of x y is equal to 0. We get p of x and q of x as, okay. So, value of p of x is 1 upon x and value of q of x is 1 minus, so here x square upon x square is 1 minus n square upon x square. Okay. Now, procedure is slightly different as I mentioned for finding singularity at x is equal to infinity that we studied in theory also. So, at x is equal to infinity, put z as 1 upon x. Okay. Then, our function p of x, which is function of 1 upon z, becomes 1 upon x means z, and q of 1 upon z becomes 1 minus n square into 1 upon x square, which is z square. Okay. Now, we have to take functions p dash and q dash. So, using formula, p dash of 1 upon z is 2z cube minus z square, okay, p of 1 upon z divided by z raised to 4. Recall this formula, okay, we derived this formula, and q dash of 1 upon z as q of 1 upon z raised to 4, okay. So, here p dash of 1 upon z is equal to, so 2z cube minus z square into p of 1 upon z, and p of 1 upon z is again z, so upon z raised to 4, so this is equal to 2z cube minus z square into z, which is z cube, so 2z cube minus z cube, so here in the numerator we have z cube divided by z raised to 4. So, that is nothing but 1 upon z, and q dash of 1 upon z as q of 1 upon z, which is 1 minus n square z square divided by z raised to 4. Now, check singularity at z is equal to 0, which is nothing but x is equal to infinity. Why? See, in this relation, if you put value of z is equal to 0, now x is equal to 1 upon z. So 1 upon 0 is infinity. Okay, so we are checking singularity at x is equal to infinity by taking z is equal to 0. So limit as z tends to 0 p dash of 1 upon z, and limit as z tends to 0 q dash of 1 upon z. Okay, now this is equal to limit as z tends to 0, okay, p dash of 1 upon z. So p dash of 1 upon z is 1 upon z. Now this is infinity. See, if you put value of z is equal to 0, so 1 upon 0 is infinity, and limit as z tends to 0 q dash, which is 1 minus n square z square divided by z raised to 4 is equal to, if you put value of z is equal to 0, so in the numerator 1 minus 0, which is 1, so 1 divided by 0, so this is again infinity. Therefore z is equal to 0, which is x is equal to infinity, is singular point, okay, of given differential equation. Now to find type of singularity, to find out type of singularity, we have to take here essential singularity, we have to prove, okay, remember this, essential or irregular. Now to find out type of singularity, we have to take limit as z tends to 0 z into p dash of 1 upon z, and limit as z tends to 0 z square into q dash of 1 upon z. Now both these limits here we have to evaluate. If both these limits are finite, then we can say this is regular or non-essential singular point. And if these limits are infinite, out of these two, any one or both are infinite, then we can say z is equal to 0 or x is equal to infinity is irregular or essential singular point. Okay. Now this limit as z tends to 0 z into p dash of 1 upon z. So p dash of 1 upon z is 1 upon z. Okay. Now this is equal to, see, this z will cancel with this, and limit as z tends to 0 1, which is 1, and this is finite. Okay, now this limit as z tends to 0 z square multiply by q dash of 1 upon z, so q dash is 1 minus n square z square divided by z raised to 4. So this z square and z raised to 4, here we have z square, and this is equal to, if you put value of z is equal to 0, so 1 minus 0, which is 1 divided by 0, and 1 divided by 0 is again infinite. Therefore z is equal to 0 or x is equal to infinity is irregular or essential singular point of given differential equation. Okay, so here we solved problem number 11. Okay, now we stop over here, and in our next lecture we will continue to solve problems. Okay.